every day. Yeah, yeah.
Ooh, baby, I love your way
every day.
Shadows grow so long before my eyes, and they're moving across the page.
Good afternoon to everybody. Please take your seats. Thank you. May I say welcome to everybody? The wind. We are gathered here today to witness the wedding of Jason and Samantha. Do you, Jason Lloyd Basson, declare that as far as you know, there's no lawful impediment to your proposed marriage here with Samantha Bradley, here present, and that you call on all here present to witness that you will take Samantha to be your lawful wife?
I do.
Good. That's good. Do you, Samantha Bradley, declare that as far as you know, there's no lawful impediment to your proposed marriage here with Jason Lloyd Basson, here present, and you call on all here present to witness that you will take Jason to be your lawful husband? Wonderful. Good. going to ask you that one again.
Don't you believe me?
Yeah, I do. The book says I must. Jason, will you take Samantha to be your wedded wife, to live together? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only for Samantha as long as you will live?
I do.
Samantha, will you take Jason to be your wedded husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only for him?
I do.
I'd like to just share a few things with you guys, and I know the wind is blowing. I just want to say a few things about marriage and relationships. Don't have any secrets. They're not good. Just want to share these things with you today. You've probably heard that marriage is 50-50. I want to tell you it's not. Okay. It's not give and take either, because normally if it's give and take, the one does all the giving and the other does all the giving. One does all the taking. Trust and honesty are the two major pillars that are going to hold up your marriage. Love is not it, but trust and honor is going to do it. I don't know if you're a great sportsman or sports people. Marriage is a bit like tennis. When we play tennis, there's a net between the two players. Don't allow the net ever to get between the two of you. Always make sure you're on the same side of the net. If the net gets between the two of you, then we play aces. You know, hit that ace, I got you. Got you. Stay on the same side, because then you're not competing, but complementing each other. My mom taught us when we grew up a lot of important things I haven't remembered too much. But what she said is, please and thank you cost nothing. But the most important is, I am sorry. I want to promise you that as the time goes on, there are going to be many times, Samantha, when you're going to think, I'm right. I'm right. And Jason, you're going to feel the same. But it's not a question of who's right and who's wrong. It's a question of harmony. So let's use first to say, I am sorry. Here down in Durban where we live, flowers are a waste of money. You buy a big bouquet and tomorrow they just wilted and think, that's half a tank of petrol. Okay? But let me tell you, flowers in a relationship work wonders. So don't forget today, don't forget special days, her birthday and other special days, come home with a flower. Communicate is important. We guys, once we get married, I don't know what happens, but something switches off and we forget to communicate. Ladies like communicating. You two have communicated well. So try and keep it that way. Communication, very important. And then the golden rule. Treat each other the way you would like to be treated. Speak to each other the way you would like to be spoken to. That is so important. Okay. Just some tips. You're going to say your vows to each other? I'm going to ask you to. In a moment, we're going to get to the vows. Meantime, I'm going to give you them over here. I'm going to ask you to repeat after me, okay? Will you face her? Hold hands, please. You face.
I, Jason Lloyd Basson.
Take you, Samantha Bradley.
Take you, Samantha Bradley.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To heaven to hold.
To heaven to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for sickness and in health.
For sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until death.
Until death.
Will part us.
And there too.
I give you.
I give you.
My word.
My word.
Samantha. I, Samantha Bradley.
I, Samantha Bradley. Take you, Jason Lloyd Basson,
to be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To heaven to hold.
To heaven to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward. For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until death.
Until death.
Will part us.
Will part us.
And there too.
And there too.
I give you
my word.
You're going to say your vows to each other.
Okay. I promise to listen to your advice and occasionally consider it. I promise to never keep score, even if I'm totally winning. I promise I admire your huge, strong, kind, and determined heart. I promise I will love you. You know me better than no one else in this world, and somehow still you manage to love me. You're my best friend, and... Sorry, what did I say? I'm joking. And my one true love. It's the part of me today that cannot believe that I'm the one who gets to marry you. You look so beautiful to me today, but know that you always look beautiful to me. You look this beautiful today, tomorrow, the next day, and the next. It's gorgeous as you are right here and right now. I will love you more and more each day of our marriage. I promise to be your faithful husband. I vow to love you when the sun shines, when the rain falls, in sickness and in health, through the good times and the bad. When you look at this ring, think of me and remember that I always love you.
Jason, you are my best friend, my person, and I promise to love, honor, and respect you throughout our marriage and through every up and every down. I am so proud that I get to call you my husband from this day forward. Now to quote your idol, MJ, let me fill your heart with joy and laughter. Togetherness, well, that's all I'm after. Whenever you need me, I'll be there. I'll be there to protect you with an unselfish love that respects you. Just call my name and I'll be there. I love you.
Can you put it up to it?
Give me my hand.
Stop it,
Samantha with this ring.
Samantha with this ring. I
marry
you.
I promise to be.
Your protector and your provider. I will always love you.
Jason, with this ring. I marry you. I promise to be a faithful wife and support you. Got it on good.
Hold each other. Can we stand, please? Father, today, Jason and Samantha made vows to each other. We've all been witness. We want to pray today, God, in this beautiful setting, that you would extend your right hand upon them, that you would bless them abundantly. As they will grow this marriage, Lord, may they, where they live, not just be a house, but may it be a home where it's full of laughter and happiness and harmony. Others come to visit them. They'll walk away and leave there saying, I wish our home was so full of joy and happiness like theirs. So today, Lord, as we stand, we want to ask your blessing upon them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may kiss your bride.
Ooh, baby, I love you. Yeah. Every day. Yeah, yeah. But no.
sunset in your eyes, brown and gray and blue besides. Clouds are stalking islands in the sun. I wish I could buy one out of season. But don't, oh no, no, hesitate. Light me that, cause your love just won't wait. Just won't wait. Ooh, baby, I love your way. Every day. I wanna tell you I love your way. I wanna tell you I will love your little ways. I wanna
ladies and gentlemen. Hello, hello. Hey, everyone seated. Please, everybody, let's give a very hearty Durban welcome to Mr. and Mrs. Basson.
Love was out to get me. That's the way it seemed. Disappointment. I saw her face. I'm a believer. And not a trace.
First of all, a very, very warm welcome to all of you this evening. My name is Dion Meiberg. I'm from Cape Town. Very, very privileged to be here. I don't know what I did to get the honor of MC this evening. But it's really wonderful to be here in Durban with all you wonderful Durbanites, extremely friendly, hospitable, wonderful people. And this evening, I'm here because Jason is like a little brother to me. He has grown up before my eyes, and it's a very proud moment. Almost feel like a father today. It's easy, son getting married. So this evening is about fun. It's about enjoying ourselves and about having a great time. But before we start, I just need to let everybody know about some very important house rules. First house rule is no smoking in the venue or in the reception area or anywhere under a roof. All smokers are requested to please smoke outside. That's to the left, where there is seating and there's a fire where you can actually throw your ashes into. For you Cape Townians, please do not throw your cigarettes on the floor. Secondly, please take note that the toilets are just at the entrance. Men are to the left, ladies are to the right. And please also take note that are septic tanks. So do not throw any pads or lilets or anything into the toilets or cigarette butts. No guests are to use the side barn doors next to the bar area. It's a busy area and is used for the service staff. And then lastly, but importantly, no vehicles are allowed to be left here overnight. All vehicles have to be removed. Apparently the cows cause some severe damage to your car if you leave it here. So your car may get humped if you leave it here this evening. So please, don't leave your cars here this evening. So, first of all, Samantha, I always knew you'd make a stunning bride, but shit, you took my breath away today. You look absolutely amazing. Jason, I've never seen you look so smart before. And what a beautiful ceremony. I'm sure you all agree with me. It was an absolutely touching, very sincere ceremony. But it's so interesting to see this couple today knowing Jason from when he was a naughty little fucker. I think first of all, we need to welcome some very special guests that are here this evening. I think first of all, Pat's sister Colleen flew all the way out from New Zealand. Colleen, a great welcome. Welcome home. I'm so glad you never brought the sheep with, because they would have been shagged if you did. Also, great welcome to the family of Jason and the family of Samantha, Bradley, all of you. Wonderful having you here. And then, of course, all the Capetonians and the invader of Durban. All the Capetonians that are here, a real warm welcome. I think, first of all, I just want to say that Shona, the mother of Jason, you have done an amazing job, Shona. Yes. To raise three such amazing children. Michael, the youngest, who I didn't know, is your loud barbecue, Shona, and Jason's best man. And Melissa, and then of course your eldest son, who's getting married today. Do you think what an amazing job you did raising such fantastic, three such amazing children? And Jason has always been a little entrepreneur. As we know, he always had wild ideas from a young child, trying to do everything. And Jason was grounded when he met Samantha. Now, you know, they say when a man normally goes to sea back in the day, when they go out to sea, they come back either with scurvy, they don't come back at all, or they come back with STDs, or prostitute with STDs. But Jason Basson came back with a pearl. He went to sea, and he came back with a pearl. He met the most amazing person who has crept into all of our hearts and has grounded him and has made him a better person and the man that he is today. And for that we say thank you, Samantha. I don't know if you all know the story of how they met on the ships, but apparently it was a princess cruise and the average age on the cruise was about 86. So very slim pickings for our poor old Jason. And apparently, while on the ship, he saw this young blonde girl that was drinking at the water fountain. Now, Sam suffers from a very rare condition called resting bitch face. So Sam had her best resting bitch face on when she was sucking water at the fountain. And Jason walked past and said, "Hello, where are you from?" And she said, "South Africa." He said, "I know that, but where?" She said, "Durban." Oh, Jason walked away, went to his mates there in the galley and said, "What a fucking bitch." Anyway, unbeknownst, Jason, typical in his charming way, goes to Pat and Sue, Samantha's parents, and he wants to give them free wine. Does he know they aren't a wine package anyway? But Jason's giving them free wine. Samantha's mother, Sue, lovely woman, says, "No way, darling, he's far too good looking to be straight. He must be gay." So, anyway. The next minute, an old Russian prostitute comes along and says to Pat, "That's my fiance." Wow, shit. Sam was like, "Fuck you." You do know they called Jason the United Nations on the ship because he had done everyone. So needless to say, that was the introduction of how Jason and Samantha met. And I thought, what a touching story. And when he got back to Cape Town, he was telling us about this girl that he met on the ship. And we thought, he's talking cock. There's no way. We thought she was fictitious. Until the day we actually met Samantha, when she came to Cape Town. Or did we come here? I think we came to Cape Town. And we couldn't believe what a gem Jason had found. And the journey of life that you have taken, Jason, with Samantha has been amazing. It's been phenomenal. As I said, knowing Jason from a young teenage boy, going through all of his antics with my brother, because him and my brother are best friends. They've been friends from school days, and how they actually met, they never knew each other, they just had the same name, Jason and Jason. So every time they saw each other, they would just hug each other and say, Lack a name, Baru. Love your name. And eventually they became friends. So having seen Jason and your life journey of where life has taken you and what you've done, I've always known from day one you're going to be successful. Because my word, an entrepreneur and a smos, I've never come across like Jason. He can sell anything. And Jason's friends here, all from Cape Town, know the area. They all grew up in Durbanville. And they were really naughty, I can tell you. They got up to a lot of shit. But he moved to Durban, and the success, and I think the amazing family that he has got here in Durban as well, Pat and Sue and Samantha, what you guys have really done and the home that Jason has created here, it really makes us all proud, and we are extremely happy to be here this evening with you. Also, I've got to welcome a very special cup, Jason's cousin, Nikki, and Yaku, all the way from Hartenbos. Where's Yaku and Nikki? Oh, sorry, I just have to tell you this story. It was in December we went on holiday. It was Sam and Jason, myself, my brother and his wife, and we went to Sedgefield. And on the way, Jason said, we need to please stop over at this place called Hartenbos. It's there outside of Mossel Bay. Now, for years I've heard about the ATKV, Afrikaanse Taal en Kulturele Vereniging. That is Hartenbos. I had never been to this place, but I heard it's like pilgrimage for the boere. You know? The Muslims go to Mecca, the Christians go to Israel, and the boere go to Hartenbos. So I've heard about this place, but I've never seen it. And my word, was that a culture shock of note? I was mortified. I never knew Urania moved to the sea. But here is a bunch of squatters squatting at the sea, using a fucking bedpan. It was classic. Kudos to you. And by the way, they live in a beautiful, gorgeous home in Durbanville. So what the hell are they squatting at the sea for? I don't know. I mean, my idea of camping is slow room service. So kudos to Jaco and Nicky for doing the Hartenbos. And hopefully El Cora Marie, who sang Hartenbos, will entertain us a little bit later. I think also to the groomsmen and the bridesmaids, maid of honor, you ladies, who looked absolutely stunning today. Absolutely beautiful. I think to the groomsmen, thank you for behaving yourselves. I know it was difficult, but thank you very much. It took quite some time. So, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to start this evening, first of all, by having a starter. Once the starter has been served, we will then move on to the speeches. If there's anything that you need, the bar, by the way, it's an open bar for certain things, so especially for the Cape Townians, don't rip the bar off. But bar is here, you all know where it is. So enjoy yourselves, and this evening is all about celebrating this amazing couple, Jason and Samantha. And today we've witnessed all these years of dedication and love that has come together. And you know, Pat and Sue, I was thinking to myself, it's your only child, so what a big day for you. What the fuck were you thinking of giving her to this reprobate? I'm joking, Jason. The two of you are the best thing that ever happened to each other. So a massive congratulations, and thank you for the privilege for all of us to be here today and to share this special day with you. Thank you.
Every time I look into your loving eyes, I see love that money just can't buy. One look from you, I drift away. I pray that you are here to stay. Everything about you tells me I'm your man. I live my life to be with you. No one.
Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you all enjoyed that amazing starter. It was really good. I must confess, I actually failed to pay homage or welcome some very special people who actually had their passports stamped to get you all the way from Umhlanga and Belito. So I believe that for the people in the north of Durban, the south coast is a little bit scaffy. So Sam actually asked me to really welcome all the people from Umhlanga that have their passports stamped to get here down to the south coast. So it's my honor and my privilege to next call up to the podium Patrick Bradley, Samantha's father. Patrick.
Thank you. This one, right?
Are you guys still there? Good evening, everyone. We've got a couple of choices here. The most iconic father the bride speech ever was my sister's best friend. Five words: cut the cackle and cut the cake. I would happily go with that, but Sam is not that happy. Anyway, let's go into my speech. My speech is all about two four-letter words. They end in UCK and OVE. Now, before we go with Dion, and guess what the first word is? They both start with L, so we talk about luck and love. Now, for me, you need a lot of both in your life. They are synonymous with going through your life from when you grow up and to when you are at where you are now. I've been very lucky in my life. Right from day one, I've been lucky. I had the most wonderful parents that gave us a grounding, Colleen and I, a grounding that has gone right through there. On that note, it's an anniversary of my dad's death today, but he would be so proud to be here for his granddaughter. I mean, we all know he is here, and we're going to drink. He'll be drinking a toast. Dion actually stole most of my speech, which is where the luck actually comes in, because I don't actually have to say much. I don't have to welcome you all yet. I don't have to say thank you for being here. The real luck is that you found your way to Umkamas. Because after they built the freeway, Umkamas disappeared off the map. Nobody comes unless you're going to go and dive with the sharks. Or come for a wedding to a fantastic venue. I've got to say that this has been a wonderful venue. I want to thank Mara. It's not my duty to thank everyone, it's yours. But I'll just relieve you of that one there to start with. The luck continues right through school, through Army, through Air Force, through sport. I've been lucky. I didn't have to work too hard, and things worked out all right. Then, 3 years down my line through my articles, came back from holiday, who's sitting at the reception desk? This little blonde puppy. Hey, and then, I must tell you, then my luck changed. Because she was one little young girl there, and there were 25 bees swarming around the honeypot there. And for 3 years, my luck was just not working. Then luckily, things turned around and love came along. And 40 years later, as the saying goes, it's been the happiest 4 years of my life. But this is not toast, but I'm acknowledging in certain things. Firstly, the mother of the bride. And everybody knows that she is the most wonderful person out. And everybody who knows me and knows her still can't understand how lucky I am that I've got her. And that's a true story. Then we're going to move on to other luck. I don't think anybody who could have met in luckier circumstances than Jason and Sam. I mean, how would you ever meet in the middle of the Panama Canal? And it was lucky that there's only one girl under 50 on the ship. But so the luck has brought us together, and it has now brought Jason's family into our lives and us into Jason's lives. And I want to reiterate what Dion said about you, Shona. You should be so proud of your kids that you brought up. They are an absolute... For you to have brought up such wonderfully behaved kids, mannered, friendly, whatnot, I can't acknowledge it enough. I really salute you. Well done. To everybody who's here, thank you for coming. The ones that couldn't be here, we raise a toast. I know that everybody would have liked to have been here. I know your dad would like to have been here. I know other friends of ours from overseas would like to have been here. I know their thoughts and wishes are all with us, so we'll all thank them, and we know that they love us here. Let me go back to love. When I look about love, there's a lot of love here for you two. Everybody here, it's very apparent that people love you, and they are so positive about where you're going to be going in your lives, and I think that's absolutely fantastic. Let's get back to luck. Jason pitched up. How lucky is that? I mean, could have had anybody. I've now got myself a son-in-law who's absolutely well-mannered, fitted into our family. They all love him, our circle of friends, they love him. He's an entrepreneur, second to none. Once he learns to add, he'll be perfect. I look forward to many long years of you as a son-in-law, as long as Dad doesn't pitch up it. No, Dad. The last bit of luck is the most important person here. Samantha, a brief history of how lucky it is about her is that I only ever wanted one child, and I wanted a daughter. Susan fell pregnant, and she was pregnant with a son, with a boy, and she miscarried. Apart from that, this wouldn't be here, I can promise you. And then the luck continued. She pitched up, I wanted to have a kid with straight hair. She pitched up with no hair, but eventually it ended up with straight hair. But I don't think there are many parents that can have had a luckier relationship with their daughter than we have had with Samantha. She is typically of an only child, independent, loyal, never helped with her homework from day one, right through her getting her honours degree, which, by the way, is going to stand in good stead when she peels potatoes and pours gin. We all can't wait for see how well she judges the potatoes and analyses them, yeah. But there are so many things I could tell so many things about you right from the... We have been so privileged to have you, that you've been involved in our lives right from day one. You've come to every family function we forced you to go to, every concert, listen. You even pretend to like my music, which is good. And Jason's pretending to like it now too, which is also even better. And that you, as you've grown up, have wanted to be part and parcel of family functions and want to spend time with your mom and I, which is so special to us, and I can't give enough accolades to that, because it's just really is what we need. As we grow old, you better start looking after me. And, anyway, this day is all about all of you. I just want to say, there was a slight misconception at the bar. I want you to drink as much as you can. Jason's been saving for years for this, so just have a full go. Eh? Just don't even think about it. Just keep going. Don't stop. I'm about to stop, though, I must tell you. This is it. I'm out of here. Thank you, Dion, for what you said, because I was going to thank everybody for everything else, but you did it all. Even the United Nations on the boat, the whole lot. Sam, you've made a wonderful choice. And Jason, you have too. I just hope that, and I know that the Bassons are going to welcome you into the family the same as we have welcomed you into our family. It's a wonderful union of the two of you, and I just hope that you will have as much luck and love as I've had throughout my life. And I just That's about it, eh? Have fun for the rest of the evening, everyone. Please enjoy.
Thank you so much, Pat. Very, very touching speech, and I just want to let you know, I know how Jason looks up to you, Pat, and you've been of an amazing, fantastic mentor to him. So thank you for the great father that you are. Right, now we get to the interesting part where we invite the best man. And this best man, I remember last when he was in primary school, or he was still in nappies, and he's now a man. So I'd like to ask you all to put your hands together for the best man, Michael Basson, Jason's brother.
Thank you, Dion. Before I start my speech, yesterday was a very special day for the groom. It was his birthday, so I'd like to sing a happy birthday to Jason. Can we start? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jason. Happy birthday to you. Okay, now that I'm in Jason's good books, we can start the speech. Now, we all know best man speeches consist of the best man absolutely roasting the groom to the max possible. But today, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to start by telling you all of Jason's good qualities. Well, let's start. I thank you all for coming today. Have a good evening. I'm just joking. Thanks for coming, everybody. I'd like to say that. And there also comes a time in life where you meet a person you'll love forever and you want to spend every second with them. They're good looking, and I mean, they're always on their game. That time in Jason's life came when he met me. My name is Michael. I am Jason's favorite brother, and he's only brother. For those who don't know me, well, that's your loss. You know, it took Jason a while to find his best man. I mean, he first went to the cleverest person he knew, and he said no. He then went to the most good-looking person he knew. He also said no. He finally moved on to the most popular person he knew, and after three times, I had to eventually say yes. Jason and I first met about 20 years ago. Funny enough, it wasn't in a bar. But it was in a hospital. I'm sure Jason was the happiest person on this planet when his time of his baby brother was born. But he had a different way of showing his love, like flicking his newborn brother straight on the forehead. And 8 months later, giving his brother his first set of stitches straight on the chin. So I knew. I didn't really know what was going on at this point in time. I mean, I was going through a lot. But I mean, I knew the following years were going to be rough. We fought a lot and pushed each other's buttons. It mostly consisted of me crying and Jason laughing. But luckily, I had a mom and a sister backing me up every now and then. You know, one day I was about 8 years old, and myself, Jason, and Melissa were at home. And my childhood dream was to go to Rotanga Junction, the place where the roller coasters, the candy, I mean, every child's dream. I'd always wanted to go there, and Jason told me he booked tickets to take me there. I bought clothes to wear for the day. I took money from my mom, sorry, mom, to buy all the cool things I wanted. You know, I was super excited as a kid would. When I eventually asked Jason, "Homie, which day are you going to take me?" To this day, I'm still waiting for the 31st of February to come. But I eventually forgave him. See, Jason and I were very different. He was always the loud, the party animal, the general animal, stubborn, and not a very good decision-making child. This lesson go on forever. I mean, I was the good child, the quiet child, the mannerly, the normal. And I mean, I made good decisions in life, but ultimately, I was the most good-looking brother. I would annoy him sometimes. He would annoy me all the time. A word my mom used for Jason was special. Most brothers would be jealous about mom calling the other brother special, but I knew that Jason was a different type of special. I mean, we can all agree on one thing. No one can compare to Jason's qualities. Jason Silver. So on a serious note, all the things Jason and I did, all the things we fought about, was because he loved me. He'd keep me up late on a school night to play games with me, even though Mom was angry. He knew it made me happy. I used to wait outside every day with a bike helmet in my hand, waiting for Jason to return from school, just so he could take me for a ride on his bike. And every day, he did so, because he knew it made me happy. Along the way, I also met some of Jason's best friends that are sitting right over there, the groomsmen. And they gave me time of day and treated me like one of their own. And I really thank you guys for that. One thing I'll never forget, that was on my 17th birthday. Jason and Samantha came down from Durban and surprised me. And halfway through the night, tears of joy. Jason wanted to go out for a smoke. And he told me, please, homie, come keep me company. You know, I went outside and we had a long conversation. And there's a couple words that Jason said to me that stuck with me forever. Those words were, homie, I promise you, I'm gonna try my best to be the father figure that you really never had. And Jason stuck to his word and he's been with my back the whole time. That's why I'm here today. Jason, you're honestly... Shut up, mother. Jason, you're honestly the best brother I could have ever asked for. Through thick and thin, you always had my back and always encouraged me to do things I never thought I would do. If it wasn't for you, I honestly don't know where I'd be today. I really look up to a man like you that has been through so much in life but pushes past it and strives for only excellence and one thing he never gives up. You're not only a brother to me, but you're my best friend. I have to say I love you so much, home dog. There's one more thing I'd like to say about Jason. Over all these years, I honestly think he has to be the best hide-and-go-seek player I've ever seen in my whole life. I mean, to this day, he has still not come out the closet. And Samantha, I think you have to be the reason for that. You're a beautiful bride and also a beautiful person. You're clever, you're hardworking, you're always determined, and you have a great personality. I thank you, Auntie Sue and Uncle Pat, for raising such a beautiful human being and that he can be married to my brother Jason. Sam, even though I haven't known you for a long time and we don't get to see each other often, you're always in Durban, I'm always in Cape Town. And Jason, I'd like you to know that Sam doesn't treat me just like your brother. She treats me like a brother of her own. And Sam, you must obviously be a massive superhero because I don't know how you put up with this guy. But I mean, just one flaw I think, Sam, you have. That is your taste in men. And the bridesmaids as well. We can all agree the bridesmaids look absolutely beautiful tonight. Everything you did, everything we did for Samantha. We wouldn't have such a perfect day without everyone here as well. I'd like to thank all of you for coming and celebrating this lovely day, where Jason and Samantha are going to have a great future together. So I say, Jason and Samantha, you're truly perfect together, and you only bring out the best in one another. I would like everyone to please raise their glasses at this point in time. And yes, Mom, you can raise your Coke as well. I'd like to say to Jason and Samantha on this new adventure, cheers to a happily ever after. Thank you.
Wow, that was... If that wasn't inspirational, then I don't know what is. Michael, you did an absolutely outstanding job. And I know for a fact that your brother has been a great role model to you, even with all of his faults, as you've mentioned this evening. But really, what an inspirational speech. Well done, Michael. I know a lot of people have spoken about Jason's antics, and we don't want to continue to rip on him. But all the years that I've known Jason, I think 80% of the time I've seen him without clothes because he loves stripping. So those of you that know Jason Silver back in the day, his old stripper name, Jason always took his clothes off. I barely saw Jason with clothes on. And in 2008, I relocated to Dubai and I had a farewell at a very, very large establishment in Cape Town called the Lanzarack, and it was an extremely expensive bar. And Jason and my brother rocked up. I think they were in the early 20s or not even 20 at that stage. And of course, Jason, typical fashion, started off with Michael Jackson pulling the crotch. And the next minute he was stripping. So he was standing eventually in his boxers while my brother was putting cigarettes out on the expensive carpets and dropping shooters all over. And some girls stole his clothes. So he was walking around the entire evening just in his boxers. But what he didn't realize is there was no button on the front. So he was going a windmill the whole evening at the Lanzarote. Needless to say, I've never been allowed back to that establishment. So as Pat said, you must please all drink at the bar, but please don't break any glasses. We don't want Jason and Samantha sitting with a bowl for all the breakages at the end of the evening. So please just be careful, you Cape Townians, with your glasses. Next up, obviously, the man of the moment, a brilliant friend, a person, as I said, who I've known for so many years, and I'm so proud of to see how far you've come and where you are. And we are privileged to be here this evening to celebrate with you, Samantha, and with you, Jason. The man of the hour, Jason Basson.
Dion, if you think you can say four or five nice words right at the end and think I'm not going to retaliate, you have no chance. Turn your hearing aid up, John. Remember, Pat said I can't add and I can't remember things either, so I need to type this out. Okay. So I'm not really one for public speeches, that's why I have a few... That's why I have a few coping mechanisms. One of them is in my right hand. And the other is that I'm picturing all of you naked right now. It's a bit cold tonight, Jason Marburg. Yeah? I'd like to say a few words before I spend the next 40 years listening. Firstly, how gorgeous my beautiful wife looks tonight. Such beauty, amazing character. I'm very lucky to call her my wife. And after being married to an honors graduate, it comes with a lot of benefits. For example, Sam was adamant to proofread my speech tonight. Before I read it. How thoughtful was that? I know sometimes I say inappropriate things, but for an occasion, but for an occasion, I'm going to tone it down a bit. Only you guys got that, okay. I'd like to say, Pat and Auntie Sue, I'd like to thank them for welcoming me into their family. I'm sure that's exactly what they pictured when thinking of the perfect son-in-law. But if not, I'm sorry. Uncle Pat, Auntie Sue, you have given me the greatest gift of all, the gift of your beautiful daughter, Sam, and I promise to thoroughly enjoy unwrapping the gift tonight. Sorry, guys. I got a cheers from Uncle Pat. That means good to go. Okay, on a serious note, I would like to thank a few special people and in no specific order. Firstly, I'll start with my mom and dad for having me. Without them, I would not be here today. My parents taught me many valuable lessons. My mom taught me that practice makes perfect. I learned that they tried for 4 years to have me. Thanks, Mom, for practicing what you preach. Thanks, Corbis. I wonder why they put you in the Cape Town side of the room. Now I know. The best advice my dad ever gave me was, son, avoid hangovers and stay drunk. So thank you, Dad, for that. Mom and Dad, I love you both very much. Thank you for giving me the best of both your qualities. Thank you for accepting Sam into our lives and treating her like one of us, making her feel like a son. I always be grateful for
my parents that God gave me, I wouldn't change a thing because I am who I am because of them today. Mom, you'll always be my first love. Never forget that. Thank you for what you've done for all three of your kids. It takes a special kind of person to walk in your shoes. Thank you, Mom. And that comes from all three of us. All right, apologies from my dad. He unfortunately could not be here tonight as he's on an important business trip to Spain. No, wait, sorry. Mitchell's plane. That's Phoenix or Cape Town. Sorry if anyone comes from Phoenix. I love it there. Yeah, thanks. Sorry, Dad, you couldn't be here. Have an open bar. I would now like to thank my friend, my banker, my golf coach, my drinking buddy, my business partner, and for the first time ever, my father-in-law, Uncle Pat. Yeah, just please note that in mine and Sam's ANC contract, I'm not allowed to ever refer to him as Dad. He's made this very clear to me. Uncle Pat, thank you for everything you have done for Sam and myself, especially for tonight. I initially wanted to mention in my speech, thank you Visa and MasterCard. Sam and I will forever be in your debt, but no need for that, now I can direct this to you. Sam and I will never forget what you've done for us tonight. Thanks very much, Uncle Pat. Uncle Pat, thanks to you, not to Sue, I'm able to live the life I've always dreamed of. And as of tonight, with the woman I've always dreamed of. Sam is very lucky to have parents like the two of you. Thank you so much for accepting me into your family the way you have. Auntie Sue, Ma, number two, I don't mean to offend anyone in saying this, but if there was a prize for the best mother-in-law, you would win hands down. Auntie Sue, I enjoy all the time with you, even though most of the time is spent with you napping. I've not met anyone like you. Actually, I've never met anyone like you. Auntie Sue, you're a very special woman. Thank you for making me feel so welcome. Your Michelin standard cooking and your all year round stock bar makes it very difficult for anyone not to love you. Love you lots, Auntie Sue. Thank you for being you and for bringing up such an amazing daughter. My best man, my buddy, my brother, Michael. Home dog, that's our nickname for each other. Thank you for being by my side today. You have made me very proud, buddy. Your words brought tears to my eyes tonight, and by the way, I've typed that already. As you people saw. Thank you, Mike. I'm very proud to be your brother. That speech was amazing. Couldn't have written better myself. Love you, buddy. And Michael, the bridesmaids that you said look so beautiful tonight, some of them are single. One of them are strongest as you don't go to, but the rest are available. And if you want to, there's beer goggles, free of charge over here. I'd like to mention my beautiful sister. Thank you for being the best sister I have. Best sister I could ever ask for, sorry. Cheers to you and your beautiful family, Charlie, and my lovely niece, Milana, our cute safflower girl tonight. Thanks to the bridesmaids, you are all so beautiful today. Thank you for going out of your way to make Sam feel very special. Especially to our maid of honor, Taylor, for throwing an awesome hen's party. Sure, but Sam got a lot of presents, eh? A lot of underwear to be specific. She came home and she showed me, she pulled out one pair. I said to her, babe, there's a thread of cotton hanging out at the back. And she said, babe, that is the back. I said, whoa. Cheers to all my groomsmen. You look very debonair tonight. Some of you are a bit Panarotti and Romans as well. Just joking. You guys are awesome and thank you for being by my side. Thank you very much for keeping your word and not forcing me to overdo it last night. I actually typed here, thanks, but that PS thanks, that thanks excludes Gert, but he was actually the one who put me to bed tonight along with my brother. Thank you very much. Apologies for my buddy Antonio that resides in the UK. He gave me all the excuses why he couldn't be here tonight. I bet it was because I didn't go to his wedding. But thank you very much, buddy, for what you've done for us. A quick thanks to our grandparents, those who are with us and those who aren't. Eleanor and Daphne, we love the two of you big time. Thanks for everything you've done for myself and Sam. Mauro and the staff for your beautiful venue. Thank you very much. Can we please have a round of applause for Mauro and the venue? Mauro said I get a discount if I say that. Andrew Draper, thank you for the amazing meal we've had and what we're about to have. Andrew Draper and his team, thank you very much. Graham, Mal, Govia, and the Coens, thank you very much for photography and videography. Mickey, the florist, thank you very much. Your displays look amazing. Shane and your buddy for the music, thank you very much. Dion, the world's best MC. Thank you, buddy. No one expected that shit to come out of your mouth. Those of you who don't know Dion, he said he's from Cape Town, he works in Stellenbosch, got a very high job, the Mediclinic Hospital Group. I know you wouldn't say so. But thanks for doing the job you're doing, Dion. Really appreciate it. So yes, thanks. Dion did take a lot of words from myself and Uncle Pat. Michael did too. But thank you all for coming from near and far. Guests flown down from New Zealand, like Dion said, all the way up from Cape Town and even Umhlanga. It's crazy how far people will travel for a free meal. If I've missed anyone, I am sorry. Please know that Sam and I are grateful for each and every one of you. Thanks for making today so special for the both of us. Sam came to me just shortly after getting engaged. Actually, it was the next morning. Remember, we were in Sun City. I popped the question, it was on Tyron's birthday. Sorry, people don't remember that. And I popped the question, Sam said yes later the next morning. We had a few drinks to celebrate. The alcohol took its effect, went to bed, woke up the next day, you wake up, your eyes hardly open, there was Sam right over me. And she asked me, babe, which day suits you better? July the 13th or the 21st? So I had to make a decision right then and there. Once Sam had found this venue, we decided on it. She came to me, I can't remember what it was, but she gave me two options. Babe, should we go with option A or option B? I said, definitely A. She says, perfect. We'll go with option B. And that was the first and only input I had into this wedding. Everything that you see over here is all thanks to Sam. She did it all. Couldn't have asked for a more perfect evening, babe. Thank you so much, my darling wife. I love you. And if you don't mind, please, can we get this party started?
Jason the man. Woo! Absolutely splendid speech. Thank you, Jason. There's an old Chinese adage that says that a journey of 1,000 miles starts with a single step. And tonight is the single step that the two of you have taken on your journey of marriage and your journey of love. And I'm sure that very soon, Pat and Sue Shona should be expecting some grandchildren. So we're hoping that's going to come soon. I believe that Samantha wanted a little bunny rabbit, little Frankie, to come walking down the aisle. But apparently Jason didn't take very kindly to that, nor did Pat. So I'm sorry your child couldn't be here tonight, Sam. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for your attention. Thank you, everyone, for being here. These are now the formal speeches. We are now within a few minutes. Dinner will be served. Please enjoy the dinner, and as Jason said, get the party started. Thank you.
Can do the thing you do. Anything you want, you got it. Anything you need, you got it.
Ladies and gentlemen, can I have your attention, please? We are now going to commence with the cake cutting. The cake over there, which is hanging precariously. So if I could all ask you to please, just for a moment, Jason and Sam are going to do the cake cutting. Thank you very much.
I sing it in a the hill for the child in his body and in his mind. He was a blue red moon like a hill for the child. He was something like a little bob chan. I will fight like a bob chan, shun like a bob chan, sing like a little bob chan. And if anybody asks me what is my name, I will say my name is Bob Chan. Now time is working 9 to 5 in the office in the group. Thank you.